Children, I hope all of you are doing well. So today we are here with another topic, that is a post-fertilization events. Children, before this we are done with the pre-fertilization events and fertilization events. In that, what we got to know, there is a formation of a gametes, means by the process of microsporogenesis and megasporogenesis. After that, there was a transfer that we call pollination, and when the pollination is done, there is a process of fertilization. So all these things we are done in the previous video. Now we are on the last topic of this chapter, that is a post-fertilization events. As you can see in this life cycle also, what is there, if you see the diagram, in that you got to know that after the fertilization there is a major event that take place in the post fertilization events, is the development of endosperm and embryo, right? You got to know from the fertilization or syngamy, there is a formation of a pan, means primary endosperm nucellus, and the zygote. So that pan will develop into the endosperm, and the zygote will change into the embryo. Embryo, actually this structure is where? This structure is inside the ovule. So finally what will happen? Ovule will change into the egg. Inside the egg there is an embryo, as you can see over here. And that seed is actually a future plant. So these things will take place in a post-fertilization events, and that we will see in this video. In post-fertilization events, or you can say changes, first thing is that is the development of the endosperm. Children, development of the endosperm actually precedes embryo development. When the endosperm start developing, during that only parallelly there is the development of the embryo take place, because for the development of embryo it needs nutrition that is given by the endosperm. So what happens in this endosperm? You know this structure that we have discussed already. So this structure is, there is a, you can see there is a two degenerative synergid cell, one zygote, primary endosperm nucellus, and the three antipodal cell that is also going to degenerate after the fertilization, right? So what happens, this primary endosperm nucellus cell divides repeatedly and forms a triploid endosperm tissues, right? And these cells are filled with the reserve food material, and actually it is used for the nutrition of the developing embryo. So this is the important role of the endosperm. And when it starts dividing, it undergoes successive free nuclear division, and it's give to a number of free nucleus inside the embryo sac. And at this stage, what we call it? We call it as a free cellular endosperm. Again, I repeat, when the primary endosperm cells start dividing, they start dividing without the cell wall formation. There is a free nucleus present, and during that stage, endosperm, we call it as a free nuclear endosperm. And after that wall formation, and that actually take place wall formation from periphery to the center, and this endosperm cells become cellular. So that is known as a cellular endosperm. So there is a two stage, that is a free nucleus endosperm and the cellular endosperm. So this is the difference between both of them. And you know very well, actually you have seen that coconut, your tender coconut that we are, the water of the coconut that we are drinking, actually it is what? It is a free nuclear endosperm. This is the stage in that there is a no cell wall formation, and we used to drink it. It's very nutritious. And the white kernel that we used to eat in that coconut is what? That is a cellular endosperm. Children, number of times we ask this question in your exam, what is the portion that we used to drink in the coconut, and what is the portion of coconut that we used to eat? So there is a difference. The water that we are drinking, that is actually what? That is a free nuclear endosperm, and the white coconut or white kernel that we are eating, that is what? That is a cellular endosperm. So this is the development of the endosperm that take place after the fertilization. So here I am showing the different stages in the development of a embryo. Actually, when we talk about the development of the embryo, you know very well in the angiospermic plant there is a two type of plant, dicot and monocot plants. But when we talk about the development of embryo, in both cases both the type of category is having a different kind of seeds, but the early stage of the embryo development are similar in monocot and dicot plants. So this is the stages that I am showing during the development of the embryo. You can see in this diagram what happens after the fertilization. There is a formation of zygote. So the first stage in the development of a plant, zygote, is a predetermined mode of development that we call as a actually embryogeny, and it gives a original mass of cell finally that we call as a embryo, right? So this is a mature embryo that you can see over here. This is a mature embryo of the dicot plant. If you see the monocot plant, again the embryo is entirely different, but these stages are similar in both the cases. So in majority of the angiosperm, the zygote start dividing. This is a fertilized egg actually. So it start dividing by an asymmetrical mitotic division. Again, I repeat, the division is mitotic, and it generates two cells with the two different fates, right? So first is the that is a smaller daughter cell that we call, and this smaller daughter cell is actually towards the challenger end. You know very well this structure is present where inside the ovule, and ovule is having a two side. One is the micropylar end, second one is the challenger end. So please remember children, when we talk about the development of the zygote into the embryo, that time there is what? There is a zygote start dividing in first of all into two cell structure. So there is one a smaller cell that is towards the challenger end of the ovule, and it is called the terminal apical, or you can say embryonal cell. And the comparatively this is a bigger cell that we call as, and it is actually located towards the micropylar end of the ovule, and we call it as a basal cell. And this cell start dividing transversely, TS means horizontally, it start dividing and give to a number of cells that we call as a suspensor cell. And these cells actually finally they are changing by this division. They are finally changing into the number of shapes that we call as actually proembryo, then globular embryo and heart shaped embryo. And finally this embryo, this stage change into the mature embryo, like this structure that we call as a mature embryo. So this is the stages during the development of embryo. So zygote to proembryo to globular embryo to heart-shaped embryo. So these are the stages which are common in dicot as well as monocot plants. If we see the structure of a dicot embryo and the monocot embryo, so there is a little bit difference between the dicot and monocot embryo, right? So if you see the structure of a dicot embryo, here is the structure. What it is having, dicot embryo, it is having a, why we are calling this as it is as a dicot seeds or dicot embryo, because they are having a two cotyledons. So a typical dicotyledon embryo is having what? It is having an embryonal axis, the embryonal axis with the two cotyledons. So these are the two cotyledons. The portion of the embryonal axis just above the label of cotyledon. So this is the label, above the label of cotyledons is known as the epicotyle. This region is known as a epicotyle, and it terminates into the plumule, or you can say future shoot also, right? So that portion is known as the epicotyle. Then the cylindrical portion just below the cotyledon is known as a hypocotyle. This region is known as a hypocotyle, and it terminates into the radicle, or you can say finally into the root tip, and it is covered by a structure that we call as a root cap. Mostly in, you can say example is the mango, apple, radish, rose. These are the dicot plants, and the radicle is covered by the root cap. So this is the structure of what? This is the structure of a dicot embryo. In that there is a presence of epicotyle, hypocotyle and the two cotyledons. So this is the structure actually. If you see in this point, so what is that? Embryonal axis is actually a main axis which divides into the different region. That's why we call it say embryonal axis, because it is having a future root and future shoot. Then cotyledons, what are the cotyledons? They are meant for the storage of the food, and they are the seed leaves actually, and they provide nourishment when the plant seed is germinating. During that process there is a formation of a primula and radicle, and for that there is a need of nourishment that is given by the cotyledons. Then epicotyle, as I told you, it terminates into the primule. Hypocotyle terminates into the radicle. What is primule? Shoot tip or stem tip, you can say. Radicle is a root tip, and root tip is covered by a root cap. So this is all about the structure of dicot embryo. If we talk about the monocot embryo, so monocot, why we call it as a monocot? Because it is having just a one cotyledon. That's why we call it as a monocotyledon or monocot embryo. So it just consists of one cotyledon at one end, right? So at one end they are having a one cotyledon, and that one cotyledon is actually known as the scutellum. So this is the scutellum, or you can say cotyledon, and it is present on the lateral side. This is the lateral side of the embryonal axis, and it is known as a scutellum. So this is monocot is having a just one cotyledons. Along with that, at the lower end, if you see, the embryonal axis is having a radicle. This is the radicle and the root cap, and it is enclosed into a undifferentiated sheath that we call as a coleoptera. The portion of the embryonal axis just above the label of the attachment of the scutellum, above the label of the scutellum, is known as the epicotyle region. And this epicotyle region has a shoot apex and a few leaf primordia enclosed into a hollow foliar structure that we call as a coleoptile. So this is what? This is a coleoptile region. This is the shoot apex. And very common example, if you will see in your book, so common example is given for the monocotyledons embryo, that is a grass, banana, bamboo, palm. So these are the example of the monocot embryo. So what is that embryonal axis? It is a main axis of embryo which is divided into different regions. Now it is very clear to all of you. Cotyledon, once it termed as a scutellum, where it is located? It is located on the lateral side of the axis. Primule and radicle is a root shoot tip and root tip respectively. Coleoptera and coleoptile, these two terms are very important in case of monocotyledon embryo, because coleoptera is a sheath covering over the radicle and the root cap, that enclosing the radicle and root cap, and coleoptile is a sheath enclosing primule and few leaf primordia. So this is all about the structure of a monocotyledon embryo. So after the development of the embryo, what will happen? It is going to be, there is a development of the seed. So if we talk about the development of the seed in case of angiosperm, so finally this structure is, or this embryo is present where? Please children, every time I am saying this structure is, all the things are actually taking place where? Inside the ovule, and ovule is enclosed by a ovary. So finally this embryo is present where? It is in the ovule, and ovule change into the seed, and seed ovary change into the fruit. So the seed are formed inside the fruit. So how the development of the seed take place in monocot and dicot, or what is the difference between the dicot and monocot seed, that now we will discuss. If you see the development of the seed, now you know the structure of the dicot and monocot embryo. So actually this is the structure that present where? Inside the embryo sac, and there is a development that embryo sac actually inside the ovule, and this structure change into what? Into the seed. So if you see the structure of the monocot or dicot seed, so little bit difference is there. What is in the, if you see the typical seed, it contains what it is having a seed coat. Seed coat is a double layer structure. Outer is a little bit hard and inner is soft in comparison to the outer one. So outer seed coat is known as a testa and inner seed coat is known as a tegmen. And along with that, the embryonal axis is having a epicotyle and hypocotyle region that is having a future plumule and future radicle. With that, there is a presence of a pair of a one or two cotyledons depend on the monocot or dicot seed. If there is a monocot, so it is having a two cotyledons. If it is a dicot, it is having a just one cotyledon. So this is the structure. Along with that, very important thing, there is a presence of a micropyle that is present. It is remains as a opening, a small opening. It is present in the embryonal axis and which facilitate the entry of water and oxygen into the seed. Children, please remember it. We ask it like this: ki what is the portion in the seed and what is the region in the seed? By that, there is a facilitation of water and oxygen entry inside the seed. So that reason is the micropyle. So micropyle remains as a small opening found in the seed coat which facilitate the entry of water and oxygen into the seed. So this is the reason. Along with that, gradually the seed start maturing, so its water content is going to be reduced and seed becomes relatively dry. If you see all the seed, for example, if you're seeing the gram or any beans, these are also what? These are the seeds. So when you see they are very little bit dry, so that time how much relatively dry? 10 to 15% moisture by the mass. So the portion from where it is attached to the stalk, that portion is known as the hilum. You know very well, hilum is the region from where it attaches to the stalk. Sometimes when the seed metabolic activity of the embryo slow down, it may enter into the dormant stage, and that is the inactive stage of the seed that we call as a seed dormancy. And when the condition is going to be favorable, so this seed germinates into the plant. So actually when we are seeing the gram seed, beans or any other dry seed, that time that is actually a dormant stage or seed dormancy of the seed. And when we when it is going to be soaked inside the water or inside the soil, they get that water and they start activate and germinate. So that is the overcome of the dormancy. So here I have shown you a few of the diagram that is in your book. One is the garden pea, you can see. One is the castor bean. Here also you can see there is a difference. If you see the cotyledons of the garden pea, or if you see the cotyledon of this castor. So in case of garden, these cotyledons are very thick, very flashy. They have a more reserve food material. If you see the cotyledons of this castor bean, that their cotyledons are very thin. Other than that, the structures are similar. If you see the monocot, you know very well there is a one scutellum and coleoptile region, coleorrhiza, endosperm. So this is the region that is the endosperm. This is what? This is the hypocotyle radicle. So and the one more thing, that is what in some seeds what happens, there is a presence of a another structure that we call as a perisperm also. So what is that? That perisperm is the remains of nucellus that we call as a perisperm. And example, very common example is a black pepper and beet, if you say. So these are what? These are the perisperm presence seed. Now if we talk about the difference, what happens, you know, this is the endosperm, and endosperm is meant for the development of the embryo. So in some cases what happens, depending on the presence and absence of the endosperm, seeds are actually categorized into two, that is the albuminous seed and the non-albuminous seed. So there is a difference that we will see. Here again, one of the structure that is given in your book also, that is a onion seed. This is also a monocot. If you see the structure very clear, there is a presence of this one cotyledon covered by seed coat. This is the cotyledon, means this is the embryonal embryo, and the endosperm is present, shoot apex. This is a micropylar, and from where it is there is an opening and it facilitates the entry of water and oxygen. So these are the structure that present in monocot and dicot seed. Depending on the presence and absence of endosperm, type of angiospermic seeds are two types. One we call as an albuminous seed and second one is the non-albuminous seed. In a simple way, you can say in those seed where endosperm is not completely used by the developing embryo, so that type of seeds are known as the albuminous seed. Simply, it is the example of the most of the monocot is having an albuminous seed. Non-albuminous seeds are those seeds in which endosperm is completely used by the developing embryo before the maturation of the seed. So there is no endosperm present in the seed. So that type of seeds are known as a non-albuminous seed. Most of the dicots is having a non-albuminous seed. So on the basis of that, there is a two type of seed also. You can say monocot seed and dicot seed. The monocot means there is just one cotyledon present, two cotyledon is present, reserve food material is usually stored inside the endosperm. Reserve food material is stored either in a cotyledon or either inside the endosperm. So that we call as a dicot seed. Embryonal axis differentiated into the radical and plumule, same with the dicot seed, but in the monocot seed, radical and plumule is covered by a sheath that we call as a coleoptile and coleorizer, but that sheath are absent in dicot seed. If you see the monocot, if you see the diagram of a maze that we have seen already, if you see again, so that then you will get to know in the monocot seed there is a presence of a protein layer that we call as an aleurone layer, right? And that layer is absent in dicot seed. So this is all about the monocot and dicot seed, how we are categorized into the endospermic and non-endospermic, or you can say albuminous or non-albuminous seeds. So this is the type of seed present in the angiospermic plants. Children, so in this video we have discussed about the post-fertilization event. In that we had discussed the formation of the endosperm, development of the endosperm, then we talk about the embryo formation, development of the embryo, the stages of the embryo, what is the difference between the dicot and monocot embryo, that we have discussed in this video. And the last portion, that is, now you know what is that seed formation is done, and we know now very well seed is inside the fruit. So how the fruit formation will take place, that we will study in the coming video. Please go thoroughly with this video. If you have any problem, you can call me and we can discuss over there. Thank you.